let me tell you, oh my friends, about this joy I'm living in. Let me take the mic, I wanna testify how I was dead and then I came to life. No more living in the dark of night. Now everything's alright. I've been changed. When you turn the page, let me take the mic, go on and testify how I was dead and then I came to life. No more living in the dark of night. Now everything's alright. I've been changed.
Good morning. Good to see every one of you here. We've got a great program this morning, and God's going to bless us in a different way, and I'm looking forward to it. Got a bunch of ladies that are just going to share Jesus Christ, and it's going to be an awesome thing. So we're looking forward to it. Glad you're here. God bless everything you say and do. All right, we're going to receive our tithes and offerings to begin with this morning. So if our ushers will come, and you just pray for God to bless you and that you bless him by giving. This offering will be, this is our tithes and offering. We'll take up another offering in a little bit for all these ladies to take back with them. Father, we thank you for this time and for your blessings. I thank you for this day that you've brought us all into your house. And we've come expecting to receive, and we're going to receive. God, bless these ladies and let them just bring forth Jesus Christ in different ways and let us receive it like you send it. Now, we thank you for the time that we can take up an offering, and we just ask you, Lord, to help us to give from the heart to please you because you have blessed us so much. And we just say we sure do love you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Let me tell you, oh my friends, about this joy I'm living in. Let me take the mic, I wanna testify how I was dead and then I came to life. No more living in the dark of night. Now everything's alright. I've been changed. When you turn the page, let me take the mic, go on and testify how I was dead and then I came to life. No more living in the dark of night. Now everything's alright. I've been changed.
Just Information Radical.
I put my hands in the air cause I know you're there.
I know it's supernatural.
I put my hands in the air cause you heard my prayer.
Ooh, ooh, ooh.
I've been changed.
Father, we thank you that we have given. We thank you for the offering. And we just ask you now, God, to give us wisdom and knowledge to know what to do with it. And let us use it to better the kingdom of God. And if we do that, God, you'll keep blessing. So thank you that each one that gave, and we tell you again, we love you. And we're looking forward to a great time. In your name we pray. Amen.
Well, good morning. I am so excited this morning to let you see what I know and have loved for many, many years through Shane's Crib. I have worked with Miss Cheryl and her team for many years through my work. I have seen many of my girls graduate, and matter of fact, several of them are here to support this morning and are still working in the ministry with them. And I just cannot explain to y'all, unless you deal with them on a weekly or monthly basis like I do, the love, the support, and the Jesus that comes out of this program. So I am super excited for you to see them today. Want to remind you at the end, they do have a presentation, but y'all know, unfortunately, the front monitors are still not working, so you are going to have to turn to the back to watch the video because they're going to tell you about the new things they've got going on. And I also want to remind you that this is church. They're not here to do a presentation. We're here to worship Jesus. So I want you to worship with them. Feel free to stand. Feel free to clap. Feel free to do whatever Jesus calls you to do this morning. Because, again, they're not here to perform. They're here to worship with you. So we're here for church today. So I'm super excited. If you don't know Miss Cheryl, I want you to please come get to know her and her team at the end. If you want to know what the face of Jesus looks like, come spend 5 minutes with her and you'll see it. You'll see it. Is that right or am I wrong, girls? All right. Well, with that, who's coming up?
Good morning. My name is Amy Wilkerson. I am a proud graduate of Shane's Crib program. I have the honor and the privilege of working there. I have been with Shane's Crib for almost 9 years now. God called me into the ministry. I have never looked back, and I have never been so blessed in my life. And really quickly, because we have a lot to share with you, I asked my family to come up here because this started way before Shane's Crib. We had praying grandmas somewhere in our line. So I want to encourage you, if you're a praying grandma, if you're a praying mama, if you're a praying anybody, you keep praying. Because I had 18 years in addiction. This is my husband. Tomorrow, he'll celebrate 9 years in recovery. He's been in prison a lot of his life. He's been, he was labeled all kinds of labels by doctors and by the prison system and by the state. And let me tell you, my God is a chain breaker, and he's a label breaker. This is our oldest daughter, Carrie. And he lost her a long time ago when he got in prison. But God is a God of restoration. Do not give up on whatever you're praying for, because their relationship was restored through Jesus. And then this is our third oldest. And I lost him when I gave him to his Nana to raise when he was, I think, 7 years old. And I got him back at 9 years old, and he's been with me ever since, and he's 18, and he is so wonderful, and we just went college shopping, and y'all pray for me, please. And then this is my beautiful sister, and she and I we've struggled in our lives, and because I came to Shane's Crib, and I added my prayers to the prayers of our ancestors, God is breaking chains. He has broken chains. They are broken. And she is right in the middle of her restoration process. And she is right where she needs to be. And it's all because of Jesus and what he's done for us. And I just thank him for choosing Shane's Crib for me to go to. And I thank him for all of the other wonderful places where people like us can go. And I pray over them today. So at this time, I do want to say a word of prayer as the praise team comes up. And also, I'm the leader of the Frontline Warriors drama team. That I'm a worshiper, that is my heart, and that is my identity. And I'm just very proud to be here with y'all today. This is my favorite thing to do, is to worship the Lord. So I just ask you to, like Miss Stephanie said, join us, worship him. He is worthy of it all. Father God, we just thank you. We thank you, Father, that you are the way maker. We thank you, Father, that you are the promise keeper. We thank you, Father, that you honor our prayers. The prayers of a righteous man availeth much. We thank you, Father, that you can break chains. You don't even need to be there. We don't need anybody to touch. We just need to declare it in the name of Jesus. And if we have faith as small as a mustard seed, that thing will be moved into the sea, whatever it is, Father. So right now, we ask that you would make a way where there seems to be no way. The people who's here and their hearts are crying out to you this morning, whatever they're crying out, Father, we ask that you would honor them, that you would make a way. And we'll be careful to give you the glory, the honor, and the praise, Father. We thank you for allowing us to be your vessels this morning and stand upon this holy platform. And we just declare, holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty. In Jesus' name, amen.
I am so proud to say that I am a Shane's Crib graduate. I lead our Frontline Warriors praise team. This is us. And if you just want to stand right where you are, we're going to go right into worship.
Testimony. I'm not dead, you're not done. Greater things are still to come. Oh, I believe. If I'm not dead, you're not done. Oh, no. Greater things are still to come. Oh, I believe. If I'm not dead, you're not done. Greater things are still to come. Oh, I believe. If I'm not dead, you're not done. Greater things are still to come. Oh, I believe. Yeah. My best days are up ahead. This is my testimony from death to life. 'Cause grace rewrote my story. I'll testify by Jesus Christ the righteous. I'm justified. This is my testimony. Oh, I'm alive. This is my testimony from death to life. 'Cause grace rewrote my story. I'll testify by Jesus Christ the righteous. I'm justified. This is my testimony. This is my testimony.
This is my story. Oh, yes, it is.
never failed me. Always never failed me. And I thank you, God.
I sought the Lord, and he heard, and he answered. I sought the Lord, and he heard, and he answered. I sought the Lord, and he heard, and he answered. That's why I trust him. That's why I trust him.
I sought the Lord, and he heard, and he answered. I sought the Lord, and he heard, and he answered. I sought the Lord, and he heard, and he answered. Oh, that's why I trust him. That's why I trust him. I sought the Lord, and he heard, and he answered. I sought the Lord.
This is about to come out. I'm not a speaker. You know, I really avoid it at all costs, but I get in these moments and the Holy Spirit just will not let me move on. And if I do fight it later, I've regret it. And I'm like, why would I do that? Why would I keep my mouth shut? So this song is special to me specifically because I'm just going to go back real quick. Just bear with me. I'm sorry. So I come to Shane's crib
5.5 years ago. I came for treatment from drug court. Sadly, not Miss Stephanie's. I wish. But nonetheless, I was sent there. I didn't want to be there. But I knew I needed it. And God just wrecked me in the best way possible. I can tell you today, not then, but today, I believe that God ordained my steps right there. I believe he called me by name. I want Shelly to be here because he knew, and 5.5 years later, something that I had a passion for. I've always loved to sing. I just would never do it because I, believe it or not, have tremendous stage fright. This is difficult for me. It is. But I started praying, and I started stepping out really on my own. And then this is what he sent me. This is my fruit. I can't even believe, like, who am I that he would bless me this way, use me this way? But it shouldn't shock me because it's what I prayed for. I sought him. I asked for this. He heard me, and here we are. And I just want to give him praise because, and really just tell anybody, if he can use me, my God, he can use anybody, I assure you. So,
okay, we're going to move on.
Okay, this is Geneva. Just kidding. A question. Can you restart that for me? This is like my testimony in a song here. I came here to give God my best. I'm not going to leave here until I do that. So we're just going to restart it.
Something miraculous happened to me. I was a criminal, and your blood washed me clean. I was destined for the grave, but you rose for me. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Ooh. Hallelujah. And the rest of the praise team is Taylor and Erica. My name is Christina, and I'm also a graduate of Shane's Crib. I went to Shane's Crib 5 years ago with Shelly, actually. And it's just amazing to sit there and see what God has birthed through this ministry, and he's using us. He's using all these graduates. You see, we don't leave. I actually am honored to say that I get to work at Shane's Crib today. God made a way, and I love it. I love the ministry. I love seeing people who we're just like me. They come in and they're broken and they're messed up and they're jacked up, and we come in with shackles on, literally. When I came to Shane's Crib, I came in a cop car, shackled from my wrist to my belly, from my belly to my feet, facing a prison sentence of 20 to 10. But my God, my God. When I first went to Shane's crib, I didn't know Jesus, really. I had just met some girls in the jail who started telling me about Jesus, because it was then where I started feeling desperate. Because I didn't want to go to prison. I'd already spent 5 years locked up of the time that I was in addiction. So I started reading the word in my cell. And I started listening to these other women just minister to me and tell me about this man named Jesus. And I got to a place where I hit my knees and I surrendered my heart. And I said, listen, God, if you're real, like they say you are, could you come into my heart and can you free me? And I didn't mean free me from jail. I meant free me from those chains of addiction and free me from the bondage that I was in and the lifestyle that I was living. Because I was selfish. I cared about me and me only. God has done so many things for me in the last 5 years. I could stand here all day and talk about his beautiful glory and what he's done for me. But some of the things that he's done most recently in my life since I've graduated Shane's crib is I got a mighty man of God. That's my wonderful husband over there, Greg. God also gave me a second chance at being a mother again. You see, I lost custody of my children in addiction. My relationship has been restored with my children, and I do get to go see them whenever I want to. But God, he answered my prayers, and he blessed us with a little baby girl named Charity. You see, I look at that as my second chance. Because now I get to train her up in the way that she could go. And that way, when she's older, she will not depart from me. And I thank God that he's done that. And that's just a couple of the things that he's done. You see, today, I still go to the jail. But I don't go to be behind the bars to be a prisoner or an inmate. Today, I go in and I teach a Bible study class to the inmates, much like the other women who did for me. And I'm humbled by that. I can't believe that God chose me, a broken, messed up person who was selfish and self-ambition all day long. He chose me to do that. I'm honored. Since I didn't have to go to prison because I graduated Shane's crib. Actually, this was one of the first churches that I came to when I was in Shane's crib 5 years ago. And I remember meeting Miss Stephanie. Where you at? There you are. But I got 20 years of probation. But a little over 2 weeks ago, I celebrated my 5-year sober date. And that same week, I got a phone call from the district attorney in Atlanta. And he said, if you can be at court next Monday morning at 8:30, we're going to terminate your probation. That's miraculous. Because I still had 15 years left. That's just the kind of God I serve. He's a miracle worker. He's a way maker. He can do things that we think that we can't, that he won't do. He will do it for you. But you got to hit your knees and you got to pray and you got to put in the work, because faith without works is dead. So if you're out there and there's something that you need God to move on, let me tell you, get into a secret place where you can reach him at the Holy of Holies. Go ahead and talk to him about any situation. It doesn't even have to be for you. It could be for somebody else. You have to decree and declare and bind those things on earth as they are in heaven, in Jesus' name. And I thank you for giving me the pleasure of speaking before you today, and I love you all, and I'm grateful to be here. In Jesus' name, we love you. Amen.
was rich, I remember who I was. I was lost, I was blind, I was running out of time. Sin separated, the breach was far too wide. But from the far side of the chasm, you held me in your sight. So you made a way across the great divide. Left behind heaven's throne to build it here inside. And there at the cross, you paid the debt I owe. Broke my chains, freed my soul for the first time.
Glory to Glory to his name, y'all. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you for this opportunity to just stand before you, Lord, and just pour my heart out. It is a big day for me. 5 years ago, I started my journey of recovery. And there is a very special person in the audience today who had such a huge part to play in that role. Somebody that I looked up to, that I wanted to be just like, who dressed good, I mean, presented herself well, and always held me to a higher standard. Miss Stephanie, I just want you to know that you are such a huge part into this story, this testimony of mine. Today I'm evidence of a sound mind. Today I'm evidence of the joy of the Lord is my strength. And I didn't always have that. I battled with mental disorders, bipolar, schizophrenia, you name it, and I took medicine for it. And Miss Stephanie, she saw something in me. She saw something in me that I didn't see in myself, but I knew I wanted. She gave me an example to live by, and she gave me a second chance when she sent me to Shane's crib. God used her in a mighty way and sent me under Pastor Cheryl, who taught me that the Lord is my healer and by his stripes that I'm healed. And I can tell you right now that 5 years ago, I was taking all that medicine, and today I take no medicine. God is my medicine. God has given me a joy that it bursts out of me. Even in the saddest of times, he has sheltered me, sheltered my mind and my heart, and just gave me a freeness that I am so grateful for. I can stand here today and tell you all the bad things, but I just want to tell you the good things, and it is possible. If you're battling with mental things, God can take it from you. Just leave it at that altar right there, and he will heal you. And I love y'all.
Thank you. Is it on? Good morning, you guys. My name is Jessica Payne, and I'm a recent graduate of Shane's Crib. In March, I graduated the program, and just last weekend, I graduated aftercare, and so I'm still with them. I'm doing sober living now as I transition into, you know, the next phase of life. And addiction was a 21-year-long terrible journey for me. It started out as a generational curse, and I started messing around and looking for the release that I should have been seeking from Jesus, but I sought it out and I found it in drugs when I was a teenager. And then the enemy was very strategic on the attack on my life. When I was 21, I gave birth to my first child, and I had an emergency cesarean, and I got my first taste of pain pills. And that began the worst bondage, you guys. Every year that passed, my chains grew heavier and the bondage grew tighter and it grew stronger, even through the birth of my two beautiful twin daughters. And eventually I found myself lost, separated from my family in the streets and on harder drugs. And if you asked me what my purpose was or if I had hope for the future, I couldn't tell you because I couldn't fathom what my tomorrow looked like because I was so busy just making sure I was okay for the day. I was selfish. I had become complacent as wanting to call myself a mom but going to visit my children when I had the time or I felt like walking over there. But God, on October 16th, 2021, Jesus went on a rescue mission for me. And he picked me up, and he put me in jail for 5 months. And that was the best thing that could have ever happened to me because I did get back down to my roots, and I learned to be still and listen. And God was telling me that there is more. There is more to this. You don't keep running, Jessica. And so he made a way, and he sent me to Shane's Crib. And when I got there, I didn't know what to do, y'all. I couldn't look in the mirror. I'd never in my life experienced not being able to look at myself in the mirror, but I was disgusted with myself. I didn't know who I was, but they loved me. They cried with me. They rejoiced with me. They laughed with me. They taught me what it was to have a relationship with Jesus Christ, and they showed me love that I just hadn't felt. I had kept myself so blocked off and hidden from everybody. And I can honestly say that my God picked me up, he turned me around, and he placed my feet on solid ground. And today I can look in the mirror, and when I look in the mirror today, I know who I am because I know whose I am. I didn't wake up this morning weary and burdened and shameful with no purpose. I woke up and came to the house of the Lord with my children and my sister and my niece and my nephew. And I got a word when I first came to Shane's Crib that everything would be restored. And as far as my relationship with my oldest daughter goes, it's getting better and better and better. And I know that it's going to be restored. And I'm walking in that faith every day. So I'm just here to say, if God can do it for me, he can do it for you. Thank y'all for letting me share.
broken as my life may be, I will give you every peace. I hear you call, I am available. I say, yes, Lord.
I am available. Have you felt Jesus this morning? Telling you, the Lord's been all up in this morning. They did not come to perform. We come to Waycross, Georgia today to decree and declare the word of the Lord. What God has done for us, he can do. One of these songs they did today, saying, they calling for our sons and our daughters out of the land of the enemy. And I'm Pastor Cheryl Maynor. I used to be the director of Shane's Crib, but I got promoted to the janitor. The housekeeper, the gatekeeper, maintenance department. But I've been enjoying it, that I've been able to release different assignments to different people. And God spoke to me yesterday as we were at another great revival. He said, I've given you capacity. That where last year you had forgot to hug. You forgot to cry because you were so overwhelmed with everything happening. And he said, I brought the warriors up. And I'm driving home, and I hear him say, you have the first generation of warriors, but I'm raising up a new set of warriors. See, at the first of the year, he told me that it was the year. I'm looking at you, and I'm talking to you. He said that the older women supposed to teach the younger women. Yeah, is that in the word? And older men supposed to teach younger men, that we're supposed to teach and guide, direct, and correct. And I said, okay, God. Okay. So this year has been full of all kind of different things. And y'all heard our praise team. I'm going to tell you, if y'all don't want to give them a hand clap, I'm going to. That's been in the making. What you don't understand, that's been in the making her whole life. But she stepped into. This ministry is stepping in. And I was thinking over there, you know, God, I thank you so very much that we are not a rehab. That you can't say, oh, a rehab come to our church today. No, 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 no. We are a discipleship program for the Lord Jesus Christ. And our mission is to come in and tell these women that has been broken. I mean, you don't even have the clues, some of the stories that's brought in to this ministry. But see, we know a God that took us from our most broken state to a healing state. And I've just been so overwhelmed to watch what he's doing in this ministry. And I want to thank you, Pastor Danny, not for just this year. You and Miss Stephanie, y'all have been beside me for so many years. I call you friend, and I call you father, because y'all have implanted inside of me, and you have entrusted. You have entrusted. You've entrusted. Just today, you've entrusted to say, I got you too. I got you this one and I got you that one. See what God can do. Because I don't know. And God is doing something amazing in this ministry. And we're fixing to step in to 12. We're fixing to step into 12 years. And you know, God has kept me going. I thank Him that literally that I am the janitor now. And I can rest a little bit. Why these mighty women? Well, Brandy, will you stand for just a moment? Turn around. See, I'm just going to tell just a real quick story about her. That's my daughter. That's my biological daughter. 5 years ago, she was a wayward young lady out there sowing her seeds. But the frontline warriors, so you don't understand, when we start calling them, y'all saw me get up and go nuts. Because, see, I understand that principle of where Amy started at the beginning. If you have a son or if you have a daughter out there or you have a grandchild out there that is in the land of the enemy, that they're still out there sowing and doing this and doing that, stand up, granddaughter. She's in her fourth year of college, and she has said, I want to work with the child of the addict mom. I want to be the one that helps the child in recovery. That what they've had to go through, because she was the one that stood on the bloodline. And she, from the age of 12 years old, she sat there and she would decree and declare, Mom, you don't have no choice but to come out of the land of the enemy, because I am your child and I need you, Mom. And it happened. And today, she directs. She's the boss, and I serve her. She tells me what to do, and I say, yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am, I will. I will go do that. Yes, ma'am. And then she'll come home, and she'll say, I forgot who I was talking to. Mom, forgive me. Like, it's all good. It's all good. But you know, this year God has trained up a mighty big staff. This is Amy, Christina, Shelly, Brandy. I'm looking around. We're missing a couple today. But he said, you know, it's time to move forward. It's time to position yourself and move to what the next step is. And I've been saying today, I've been crying there. I was crying yesterday. And I was like, God, what are you doing? What are you doing? What are you doing? What are you doing? And he says, I'm raising up a mighty army. A mighty army. A mighty army. And you just keep moving, and you keep going the way I tell you. Don't you look over here. Don't you look over here. Just keep your eyes on me. So that being said, I'm going to switch the gear for just a few minutes. 20 months ago, God spoke into my heart. And I looked at Amy, and I said, God ain't telling me that. And she says, yes, he is, because he's telling me too. Okay. So 20 months ago, the Lord said, I need the next generation. We need to work on the next generation. The next generation needs to be saved. They need to be snatched out. They need security. They need healing. They need all of these things. And I said, God, who am I to do this? But anyway, God spoke into our hearts to step out on a massive, massive endeavor. I mean, it was massive. At least it is to us. To purchase 5 acres of land and to build 5 homes on there so that these women at a certain part of the program that we could walk in and go get that child from either if that child is in foster care or if that child is here, there, whatever, and to start working not only with the mother, but to put the children back in the home with the mother, and so they could acclimate back together before they go out there. So with these five homes 20 months ago, I don't know who does Facebook in here, I don't know, we ain't gonna get there. But I had a news feed, a pop-up, this morning, to pop up on my news feed, and it was my grandson and a couple more guys literally setting the temporary pole. Now, y'all, I'm talking about 1 year ago today. 1 year ago today, we're putting in a temporary service to build five houses, okay? We're just speaking it out. We got that pole there. And we started on a mission 20 months ago. That was a year ago, though. God, are you serious? $500,000? But see, I've learned through the journey that, you know that song, through it all, I've learned to trust in Jesus. I've learned to trust in God. So through it all, he said he gave me an assignment. Cheryl, just step and I'll show you. So that being said, $500,000 20 months ago, a big God, a big dream, and a huge vision that to bring kids into this ministry. And today I want to say to you, we've raised that $500,000. We've raised it. And when I say we, I am talking about the Father has blessed us to be able to come out and to minister to y'all. We've watched many people's lives be changed. We've watched women's lives, women come into the program by being in a setting like this, that they walked up and said, you were talking to me today. How do I get into your program? But today, we still have a need to finish this product. This project. And I love excellence. I love to finish what I started. Y'all, I want them to have carports. I want them to be able to study being in the mud, getting out. I want to be able to gravel the road that they have to run down, and a driveway to park their vehicles. So today, that's what I'm asking the Lord for, is Lord, pave the way. I'm asking you to pave it. Just go on and pave it. And we'll be, it is well. So, I want Pastor Danny to come up here with me. But we want you to turn around and we want you to watch the video. Y'all know how to do this.
Has been impacting women for over the last 10 years. It's time to break the cycle of addiction, pain, and trauma. It's time for the next generation. We have seen countless mothers, daughters, sisters, and wives come into treatment bound and leave free, and we long for that to be the case for their families too. In an effort to help women who complete treatment be all God meant for them, we have opened The Villages. The Villages is a place for families where families can become families once again, and children can be placed back with their mothers. It's a safe place where mothers are supported and children can be thriving in an environment that is conducive to growing and healing. The Villages currently sits on 5 acres located behind our Living Waters facility in Jessup, Georgia, and is a place for five tiny homes. These tiny homes at 750 square feet have two bedrooms and one bathroom, which is perfect for the mom coming out of recovery and being able to reunite with her children once again. With two completed homes, every house is named after a woman. Grace and Hannah have already been built, but we have a vision of a total of five, and we need your help to make the other three happen. Help us today to see faith, charity, and promise become a reality. You can be the change to a child's future by giving today for the villages. Are you ready to see families restored one family at a time? You can go to www.shanescrib.org and make a difference by giving to our ministry to help make the villages possible. Thank you for making the difference in this next generation.
And that young man, a little boy that you saw right there, he's actually in our children's program. They was not able to be here today, but he's a vital part of the ministry. And we're fixing to within the next 4 weeks, we're opening these homes. We're going to dedicate the other three homes. And I want to say thank you. And before I turn this over to Pastor Danny, I never want to leave anywhere without an opportunity to tell you that Jesus loves you. He hears you. If you're here today and you do not know Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, I mean, He's waiting. He's literally waiting for you to make that next step, just to step in and just watch what He can do in your life. He will wreck your life for the good. But if you're a mom and you're a dad and you're sitting here and you said, or a grandparent or an uncle or a child, like my granddaughter was, she was going to these rallies and she was waiting on God to move on her behalf. If you're here today and you say, I'm just asking, just gently just put your hand up and say, that's me. That's me. I had that child out there. They might not be on drugs. They might be just out there in the land of the enemy. But we want to just come in a corporate prayer with you that God hears you, God knows you, and God knows right where that child is. They know it. I mean, if they're in a motel room or if they're on the streets, or they might be in the Hilton Inn living life and have all the worldly things in life, but they still don't know Jesus. They still don't know Jesus. And I'm just going to ask you by the hand, but just showing of the hand, do you have a wayward child that you want these frontline warriors to put on the bulletin board? As we can say, Kettle Creek, this was their need. We have one lady that raised her hand, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. We've got 12. We have 12 people in here that said, that I could count, and there might have been more, that said, hey, I do have that child. I do have that situation in my life. Hey, will you remember me at the cross? Remember me at the cross. And Pastor Danny, I'm fixing to hand it over to you, but I just want to pray a closing prayer for us, and then I'm going to hand it to you. Heavenly Father, we just come before you today. We humble ourselves before you. Father, we thank you that you did show up, Holy Spirit. You come into this place. And Father, I know by 12 hands that you touched their lives, and they're sitting here today, and they are in a pursuit of you going out. So we ask you right now to send out the angels, send out the warring angels, send out the ministering angels. Go to the places that needs to be gone to, Father, because only you know where they're at. God, your word for our ministry this year is for it is written that our eyes have not seen, nor our ears heard, or has it even entered into our hearts, the things that you have planned for us because we love you. So, Father, these people, they love you. They love their grandchildren. They love their sons and daughters and their whoever. They love them, but you love them more than they could ever imagine. So, Father, we say right now in Jesus' name that, God, that you go before us, you go before them, and you touch these family members, and you bring them forth in, and that they can be able to say that I once was blind, but now I see. And God, we claim your word today, because your written word is what's going to set the captives free. We praise you today. We thank you today as we leave this territory of Ware County. Father, we plead the blood of your Son, Jesus Christ, over this territory, over the drugs, over the prostitution, over the homeless. We just speak your name, Jesus, in this realm, in this territory. And we give you praise, we give you glory, and we give you honor. Amen.
Cheryl, I want to tell you that you said you had 12 people raise their hand. These are not only my sheep, these are my children. And I would ask you to put Kettle Creek Church on that board and pray for us, because I think we need it. I'd love to see everybody in our church have the courage to walk up here and hang your problems on this cross. I'd love to see that victory come forth that we so desperately need, because God loves us, and we've all got problems. We've all got problems, and no matter what our problem is, it's big to God. He can take care of it. He's concerned about it. So I thank you for coming. You've been faithful and good to our church, and you girls, your ministry is wonderful. It's wonderful, and I thank God that you had the boldness to stand before him and stand before his people and proclaim the gospel and thank him for what he has done for you. And I think this church, we need to give God some glory today. And we don't want to praise these girls, because they do it because of God within them. So I want you to give one more big hand to God for sending them to us today. Would you do that? Amen. 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 It's a good God we serve. Kim, thank you for all your work and for what's going to happen. Brandy, for what you're going to do and how God's going to lead you. And Cheryl, for just taking them to this point. Taken to this point. I was sitting there a while ago, and I had the question, why do we clap hands? You wonder why you do that? They do something, we clap. And it's a wonderful thing, because we know why we clap. We've enjoyed it, and we're saying thank you in one way or another. I'm going to ask you this morning to reach into your billfold. I want you to say thank you again. That's a massive project they have going, but God has the means to give it. And who knows what will come from here. Doesn't matter whether it's a dollar or $1 million. Doesn't make a bit of difference. God is going to use it to do what he wants to do with it. So he'll take those little fish and those little pieces of bread, and he'll multiply it. When it gets through, there'll be 12 baskets left over for the next project. That's the way it does. So I'm going to ask you to give this morning. And just give from your heart. Whatever you give will go straight to them. Every bit of it for the kingdom of God, and they'll use it right. So pray with me before we give. Father, I thank you for this time. I thank you for the opportunity of being able once again to see you working through these girls and the blessings that they bring to other people by being truthful and sharing with us their lives. Now, God, we don't want to clap. It comes to a time where we want to do something else. We want to give. Let's just put our clap into action. Let's begin to give from the heart. And God, you've already told us, it doesn't matter what you do. If we give unto you and do what you tell us, you'll send it back to us, pressed down, shaken together, and running over. So I thank you that for each person that's going to give and the way they're going to do it. And we just tell you, we sure do love you. In Jesus' name, amen.